Hello students, and welcome to this week's video message. When I was in school, by the end of the school day, it always seemed like I was starving for food. My mother would always tell us what she was making for dinner the day before, so I would think about her meal all day during the school day. Now, I want you to picture this. If you knew that you were having a dinner, a healthy dinner with vegetables and chicken, and you came home from school and your parents said, "Well, guess what? I'm not making that dinner that I promised." Instead, she opens up your mom or dad may open up a box of donuts and says, "Here's our dinner." Now, some of us may actually like that if you really like donuts and junk food. Now, imagine this. The next day, so you had donuts for dinner the night before. The next day, you go to your parents and you ask, "What's for dinner?" And they open up a bag of potato chips and says, here's your dinner. And then the next day that you go to them, "What's for dinner?" And they give you Hershey bars. Now, even if you really like junk food, or even if you like those snack foods, there's a chance that after eating junk food for a while, you'll be craving vegetables and chicken, healthy foods. Now, we know that our parents would never make us do that. They would never make dinners like that because they know that it's important to feed us food, healthy food, healthy foods so that we can grow foods like fruits, vegetables, all so that we can grow and be healthy and be stronger. Our parents always want to make sure that we're healthy. Do you know who else wants to keep us healthy? Well, the answer is Jesus. Let's open our Bibles this morning to John chapter 6, and let's read verse 35. Then Jesus declared, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never go hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. So you may be asking yourself right now, what exactly does that even mean? Well, let's look at it from a physical standpoint. When we eat, our food does a couple things. One, it satisfies our hunger. And two, it helps sustain us and does things for us like give us energy. Now, when it comes to our relationship with Jesus Christ, it's kind of similar. We each have a spiritual hunger that can only be satisfied by having a healthy relationship with Jesus Christ. In that verse, Jesus makes it pretty clear that we need him if we're going to survive. We need him if we're going to be healthy and sustained. Him calling himself the bread of life, it's really, really appropriate. Now, think about your relationship with Jesus for a moment. And think of this example. On Sunday, let's say on Sundays, we choose to eat a really big, healthy meal. Okay, a great meal, vegetables, chicken, and everything. But on Monday and Tuesday, you decide that you're really not going to eat that much. And on Wednesday, you have a semi-healthy meal. And on Thursday, you just forget to eat entirely. And the weekend, you have unhealthy meals. Now, let me ask you this. Do you think that it'd be healthier if you would just eat healthy every single day, or to eat like the example that I just gave? So the answer would definitely be to eat healthy every day. But there are so many of us, and myself included, who we go to church on Sunday, okay, and we load up on healthy Jesus food, and then on Tuesday, Wednesday, or Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we're struggling because we're not eating as healthy as we did on Sunday. On Sunday mornings at church, we'll sing, we'll read the Bible, we'll pray. But as we get away from Sunday, sometimes we can get away from that. And all those things are really healthy for us to do. So in order for us to have our spirit be sustained and healthy, we need to make sure that we invite Jesus to be part of our everyday. Doing this constantly is healthy for our spirits. It's healthy for us to do. So for this week, we have some discussion questions that you can ask your teacher or ask your mom or dad, just to kind of talk about them and see where you're at. Here's a discussion question. Why is it important for us to eat healthy food? Why is it important for our spirit to be fed healthy food? Does Jesus only want us to communicate with him on Sundays at church? Think about that, because so many of us, and myself included, we want to be healthy. We want to feel great. And really the only way that can happen for our spirits is if we're eating healthy food that's from Jesus, the bread of life. Thank you for watching, everyone, and God bless.